loaded with goods. It was to get a letter from the Ministry of Energy and Petroleum indicating that the ship is authorized to carry and offload the cargo to in Kenya. Who cleared the Njeri ship to travel to Kenya? How did it offload? Over the weekend, we were told that the deal has resulted in so-called structured sourcing of the dollar. If that is the case, why has the exchange rate not improved? How come it has not lowered the cost of oil? What benefits have the so-called structured sourcing of the dollar brought for Nigeria? We are being told that since the deal, you have stopped paying for oil in dollars. We believe that Kenyans don't care whether oil is paid for in dollars, shillings, or rupee. They care about the cost of oil. Nonetheless, we are challenging the government to share with Kenyans evidence of payment of oil in Kenya shillings. Show us documents indicating when the payment was made in Kenya shillings, the bank account, and the recipients of the payment. This regime has told Kenyans so many fictitious stories that only documentary evidence will help the country separate fact from fiction. The oil companies and the Ministry of Energy and Petroleum have claimed that it is easy to verify that corporate tax is being paid by the oil companies. We agree that this shouldn't be a difficult task. So we are asking these firms to table the evidence of meeting the corporate tax obligations. Don't tell us, show us. We hope the Kenya Revenue Authority is listening to our demand for evidence of corporate tax compliance by Oryx, Galana, and Gulf Oil Companies.